cup of white sugar. One fourth cup packed light brown sugar. One fourth cup packed white. One teaspoon vanilla. Five cups of packed light brown sugar. One egg. You're doing excellent. One and one half cups of all-purpose flour. One half teaspoon of baking soda. One fourth teaspoon of salt. Always add just a little extra. Oh, 3/4 cups of chocolate chips. Preheat the oven to 350 and microwave the butter for about 40 seconds to just barely melt. Cook only for 8 to 10 minutes and let it cool for 2 minutes. Judges, how do you think they are? Why do you think they're thumbs up?
Because it's sweet and salty at the same time. I'd give it 10 stars.
Amari?
What do you think about your cookie?
It's good and it's salty.
What do you rate it? 10 out of 1. Cammy. What do you think about the cookie?
It's good.
1 out of 10.
9. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, judges. And Wallace Weekly. Do you guys want to come have a taste?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hi, this is Jacob and Francisco, and we are going to talk about the top speeds of 5 fast cars. First up, the Lamborghini's top speed is 217 miles per hour.
The Ferrari's top speed is also 217 miles per hour.
What a coincidence!
The Mustang Shelby's top speed is 169 miles per hour.
The BMW's top speed is 155 miles per hour.
Last but not least, the Bugatti Veyron with the top speed of 254.4 miles per hour. That's fast! That's all from Jacob
and Francisco
from Wallace Weekly. Tell us what you think about the fast parts in the comments below. Bye!
President's Day is coming up, but do you really know what it's about?
President's Day is coming up, but do we really know what it's about?
Well, we are going to tell you what President's Day is really about.
President's Day is usually known as Washington's birthday. It's a federal holiday celebrated on the third Monday of February 20th in honor of George Washington.
Although it could occur on February 15th through the 21st, it's also an occasion to remember all presidents, not just George Washington himself.
This is Addie.
And Joshua.
And we are signing out from Wallace Weekly.
Comment down below what you call President's Day in your country.
Bye! Bye.
Hello, it is Rhea Stein with my Igor.
Hi, folks!
And today we will be making slime. Our first thing we need is one, a thing to put your stuff in, and then Elmer's glue. You can use it as much as you want. Just pour it in there. And then you need 1 teaspoon borax with water. And then you just pour it in there. Mix it. And here's the final result. Will you hand me the food dye?
There you go.
And here's my final result of my slime. I hope you can make this at home. It's very easy and cheap. This is Rhea Stein and Igor signing off from Wallace Weekly.
Have you ever heard of a cool place called the Everglades?
No, where is it?
The Everglades is in Florida.
Oh, what is the Everglades?
The Everglades is a network of wetlands and forests fed by river flowing.
Well, can we get started on it?
Sure, let's start with animals.
Well, there are birds, mammals, and reptiles, plants, and vertebrates, amphibians, mollusks, and fish.
These are some birds. Brown pelican, snowy egret, resident tern, crimson plover, Everglades snake pipe, and a great egret. A great egret is 40 feet high. The wingspan is 50 inches. It eats fish, other birds, invertebrates, small mammals, reptiles, and amphibians.
These are some mammals. Florida panther, Florida black bear, Everglades key deer, lower key marsh rabbit.
The reptiles are American alligator, American crocodile, eastern indigo snake, Atlantic salt marsh water snake, and blue-tailed male snake.
Some plants are four-petaled pawpaw and Florida bunny mint.
Amphibians include a gopher frog, flatwood, and a salmon.
Fish are Atlantic sturgeon and short-toed sturgeon.
Wow, those are some cool animals.
Yeah, they are.
Do you know why we should keep the Everglades safe?
No.
Why? We should keep the Everglades safe because only some plants and animals live there and could extinct if we do not keep the Everglades safe. This is Michaela
and Cameron,
and we are signing out from Wallace Weekly. Bye.
Hey, it's Rhiannon.
And Michaela.
And we will be talking about the top horror films of all time.
Are you scared?
Yeah.
know.
And why don't you do the first few?
Okay, I will. First up is The Shining. It was made on May
23rd, 1980. That's not that soon.
If you say so. Next up is The Exorcist. It was made on December 26, 1973. The third horror film is Jaws. It was made June 25, 1975. The next famous horror film is Alien. It was made May 23, 1979. It was directed by Ridley Scott. It is rated R. The last one I will be saying is really scary. It is The Chainsaw Massacre. It was made in October 1st, 1974.
Shh, that's baby stuff. Listen to mine, you're really scared. First on my list is A Nightmare on Elm Street. It is 1 hour, rated R, and released 1984 by Wes Craven. Next up is a scary Movie by Wes Craven again. It is 1 hour long. 1 hour and 30 minutes. Third is Saw, 1 hour and 43 minutes. It was released November 17th, 2004. Another one I found was The Tale of Two Sisters. It is rated R, released in 2003, and is 2 hours. The last one I found is Kim Ji-won. It was directed by Tave Hooper, It was released June 4th, 1982. It is PG and 1 hour 50 minutes. 1 hour 50 minutes.
Wow, those are scary.
See, I told you yours was baby stuff.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, this is Michaela.
And Rhiannon.
And
sweet dreams.
Food companies may advertise natural flavors, low calories, and vitamins A to Z,
but they're much less likely to promote their use of fish bladder, sand, or human hair.
The cochineal beetle, for instance, is often found in red food dyes used to color everyday food and drink products, including Starbucks, strawberry frappuccinos, and smoothies, before the coffee chain phrased it out following an uproar from the vegan community.
Between yogurt, macchiato, cherries, jams, cakes, and tomatoes products, you probably consumed at least 1 pound of red dye in your life. That means that you have ingested at least 70,000 cochineal beetles, according to a petition in Change.org.
One key ingredient to Wendy's chili is an anti-caking agent called silicon dioxide, street named sand or glass powder.
Cellulose or virgin wood pulp that is more commonly identified as sawdust is an ingredient found in shredded cheese. It keeps the shreds from clumping up. Cellulose also appears in Kraft Parmesan cheese.
This is Ella.
And Sierra.
And Annalisa.
And we are signing out from Wallace Weekly.
Bye.
Hi, I'm Dory.
And Rhiannon.
And today we are going to be talking about the extinction of bees.
Scientists have been reported that bees are going to be extinct and dying off.
Wow.
Since 2006, beekeepers have been noticing that the bee population is getting low.
Did you know that bees pollinate plants and flowers? And if they don't pollinate plants and flowers, we won't be able to breathe.
The honeybee colony collapse. Their disorder has recognized as such an urgent that the bees are disappearing.
It's Dory.
And Rhiannon.
And we are signing out from Wallace Weekly. Bye.
Hi, this is Jacob
and Amari.
And we are going to talk about 4-H.
In 4-H, you have to take animals like lambs, pigs, goats, and steers.
There is another part of the animals. It is called small stock. You can show is a
rabbit, chicken, turkey, and etc.
There is another different part of 4-H. There is something called clover bud.
To show animals, you have to be over 9 years or older.
You have to take care of animals for so many months.
When you go to fair, you get money. This is Jacob
and Amari,
and we are both signing off.
And we are signing out from Wallace Weekly. Bye.
Hello, this is Ella.
And Sierra.
And Addie.
And we are doing the Bean Boozle Challenge.
Okay, I'll go first. Someone take one. I'll take this one.
I don't want that one.
I got either spoiled milk or coconut.
This one's either Barb. I know this one. This is Barb or Peach.
Hey!
Can I redo mine?
I'm allergic to it.
This is either a smoothie or
I got peach.
Yeah, or dead fish. Yeah.
I got smoothie.
Okay, I'm so scared though. This is either buttered popcorn or rotten egg.
That's good. Bad for you.
Rotten egg is not good. Okay?
No, this is good. This tastes like strawberries. I'm
scared. Hold on, I need to smell it. I'm a cheater, buddy. Oh my god.
Eat it! You're such a cheater!
Ella's a cheater!
It's my cake.
But cheater.
That was good. It smells like
I need to do another one.
Ella, do you
want me
to do another one? Oh, I'm doing another one. It kind of tastes like dead fish at the end, but... Okay.
Oh no, there's only three left!
You guys aren't allowed to look.
Done.
You're taking that one. No way am I taking that one.
This is either dead fish or...
Smell it!
Okay, let's stop and check it out.
You poured it!
Oh my god!
Hi, this is Jacob
and Francisco.
And we are going to talk about
five cards.
Wait, cut.
Nina!
Okay, cut.
Atlantic sturgeon. Short-nosed sturgeon. Wow, these are some cool animals.
Yeah, they are.
Do you know why we should keep the Everglades?
Go!
Hi, it's Rhiannon.
And I'm Kayla.
We will be talking about the top horror films of all time.
Are you scared?
You're supposed to scream.
Oh, yeah.
The next famous horror film is Alien. It was made May 23rd, 1979. It was directed directed by Ridley Scott. It is rated R. The last one that I...
Like, now-ish.
Oh. Hey, it's Rhiannon.
And Michaela.
And we will be talking about the top horror films of all time.
What the heck?
That's baby stuff. Listen to mine to get really scared. First on my list is A Nightmare on Elm Street. It is 1 hour, rated R, and released...
No, I don't want to close
it. How long is your thing? It was made in October 1st, 1974.
Shh, that's baby stuff. Listen to mine to get really scared. First on my list is A Nightmare on Elm Street. It is 1 hour...
So folded.
Yeah, I know it's folded.
Really?
Can someone do another thing? Food companies may advertise natural flavors, low calories, and vitamins A through Z,
but they're much less likely to promote their use of fish, bladder, sand, or human hair.
Miss Clark, please report.
Food companies may advertise natural flavors, low calories, and vitamins A through Z,
but they're much less likely to promote their use of fish, bladder, sand, or human hair.
Miss Clark, please report.